And pray that you send forth the Holy Spirit in each one of us so that we may continue your mission, and we may also be guided in everything that we do and in everywhere that we go. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so once again, good evening, everyone. Last week, we weren't able to see each other because you had your prelim exam. So, I am actually done checking your exams and also with the grades. So, hapon, no? Since I do not have any class man sa first year, so nag-compute na lang ko sa grades ninyo. And I am happy, you know, to inform you that most of you, if not all, no, got high grades as usual. So, like what I've mentioned, I will be uploading them in your Google Classroom probably by next week. So just be patient. Okay, syempre di man ako na madali-dali. I also have other works, no, sa ako ang full-time job. But rest assured na I will be able to post them next week since I am already done. Let me just share my screen for a while. Okay, so basically, we're not going to finish the entire slides for this evening. Okay, medyo ubay-ubay man, 45 slides. We're just going to continue this one probably by next meeting. So, welcome to Lesson 2, Part 2, which is the cultural features of Negros Occidental. Part 1 of Lesson 2 is the history of Sagay. So, basically, we're now going to cover the entire province of Negros Occidental. So, Negros Occidental faces the island province of Guimaras and the province of Iloilo on Panay Island to the northwest across the Panay Gulf and on the Guimaras Strait. We are actually known as the sugar bowl of the Philippines since we produce, no, almost, I think, 70, no, half to 70% of the country's sugar. At the same time, we also have the slogan nga, land of sweet surprises, no? Taken from, syempre, we are the large producers of sugar sa entire Philippines. So, the primary spoken language is Hiligaynon. Although, some of the municipalities and cities that are facing Cebu, no, just like in San Carlos City, I cannot speak in Hiligaynon, no? Bisaya man may, because we are facing, because we are facing Cebu province. Okay? Sagay, nasa 50-50, no, syempre, because it's located on the northern part, and matunga siya, no, either Hiligaynon, but mostly Hiligaynon, majuna, no, and Bisaya, okay, and then those municipalities and cities that are facing Panay Island and Guimaras, no, like Bacolod, those cities actually speak, or those cities or municipalities na nag-face sa Panay are Hiligaynon, ilang spoken language. So, ang predominant religious domination is Roman Catholicism. Although, naaapoy uban ng mga negrenses that practices other Christian denominations like Aglipay or Baptist, born again, no, napayuban nga ga practice po sila og Islam, no, sa mga Muslim na to nga brothers and sisters. So the capital of Negros Occidental is Bacolod. It is also the seat of government and the most populous city of the province. When we talk about populous city, daghan og inhabitants. Despite that it is the seat of the government, it is also governed independently as an urbanized city, with a population of 2,497,261 inhabitants, it is the most populated province in Western Visayas. So, kung ato alang siyang i-compare within Visayas, second most populous province. So, sunod rata after Cebu. Okay? And, if i-rank siya sa entire Philippines, ika-number 8 ta sa pinakadaghan og population. Let us now proceed to the geography of Negros Occidental. So, Negros Occidental is in the western side of Negros Island, and it is the fourth largest island in the Philippines. Basically, sa Negros Island class, we share it with Oriental, no? We used to be as one, but later on, na-divide siya with Occidental sa Western Visayas and Oriental with Central Visayas. So, ang total land area is 7,802.54 square kilometers or 3,012.58 square miles. If ato ang i-include si Bacolod sa Negros Occidental for geographical purposes, the province is an area of 7,965.21 square kilometers or 3,075.38 square miles. So the province is basically, no, 375 kilometers or 233 miles long from north to south. So ito siyang i-measure from north to south sa Negros Occidental. So na siya sa 375 kilometers long. Ang surrounding areas, no, sa Negros Occidental is syempre, sa north, we have the Visayan Sea, Panay Gulf on the west, Negros Oriental Province, and Tanyon Strait sa east. So, Tanyon Strait is actually the body of water nga mga kundinta mo cross, no, going to Cebu. And Sulu Sea on the south. Negros is basically volcanic. So, we did made mention palandaan sa history of Sagay nga the reason why abundant kaayo ta, not only with tall mahogany trees, and pwede po siya, no, nga, tamnan noog. Manandaghan kayo ta sa Negros Occidental o kanang mga koan class, mga sugarcane plantations, and then daghan po kaayo ta, not only with sugarcane, but other pa dyan nga mga plantations like corn, coconuts, no, for them to be made into copra. Then, kung ito ka sa Canlaon mismo, nga dool sa Mount Canlaon, syempre, they're very abundant there with different agricultural products. Because we have Mount Canlaon to thank for, and that is why Negros is basically volcanic, that is why our soil in our province is ideal for agriculture. Arable siya. So, 80% of all land in Negros is arable and is also cultivated for agriculture. So, dili lang agriculture, no, nga we are also known for. Later on, I am also going to mention when it comes to the economy and food and agriculture, nga daghan pa po kaya tag industries nga kung diin ta nagkuha po og what you call this kind of mer- na dependent ta, no, it comes to economic growth to this several industries, not just with agriculture. No, naman tay mga BPO companies, mining, fishing, mapo na ang one of the contributions sa ato ang economic growth, no, kung mga several industries nga kung na-mention. Okay, wait, for kidding mo. Mo next ako ang slides. Okay. Let's now proceed to the administrative divisions. So, in here, class, no, These are how many municipalities and cities and even barangays na nag-divide sa Negros Occidental. Basically, ka-comprise sa Negros Occidental og 19 municipalities, 13 cities, and then gi-subdivide further into 662 barangays. So, out of all the provinces, guys, in the Philippines, si Negros Occidental has the most chartered cities. Mayong itag most chartered cities, daghan nga na-convert from municipality to city. Although Bacolod serves as the capital, like what I've said just a while ago, it is also separately or independently governed from the province as a highly urbanized city. Let's now proceed to the demographics. So, take note that the population of Negros Occidental here is not updated. So, this is based on the 2015 census. So, very, very, very outdated na jud kaayo siya. But based on the 2015 census, maabot sa 2,497,261 no, ang population ni Negros Occidental. So, that is still, ga-exclude pa siya ni Bacolod. Ay, wait. Sorry lang. Pero kung itong i-include si Bacolod, guys, no? For geographical statistical purposes, no, na as a 3,059,136 no ang population ni Negros Occidental if ato ang i-include si Bacolod. Ang density niya is 384 per square kilometer or 995 per square miles. Okay. So pila na karon ang population ni Negros Occidental. Sorry kung nag-check na. Okay. Pilang population ni Negros Occidental karon nga 2024. So, largest population dropon, no, si Negros Occidental with 2,623. So, gamay ra ang napuno, no? This, ang 2015, sorry ka ba na sa mong iro, dyan, no? At sa 2015, 2,497,261 ang population ni Negros Occidental. Years later, abot atag 2024, gamay rin na po, no? Pero at least, no, nag-increase itong population. 2,623,172 ang ato ang population. And kita ra Japon ang largest population sa Western Visayas. Followed by Iloilo with 2,051,899. So, ang density niya, class, is kada squared kilometers, no, nasa 384 ang tao, no? 384 people per square kilometer. Or 995 kabuk tao, or ka, I don't know how to convert that to kung ano. 995 katawo per square miles. As usual, we are called Negrenses, no? But sometimes, tawagon po tag Negrosanons. And many are either of pure or mixed Austronesian heritage with foreign ancestry. And I don't know if ako na siyang na-mention, but the reason why mixed ta, no? Ang Negros Occidental, mixed siya with like mga mestizos or ng mga Spanish, no, or Chinese, kay tungod, no, ang kanang mga mestizos sa Manila or sa Luzon, they traveled to Negros Occidental so that they can plant or they can start their sugarcane plantation knowing that our land is good for agriculture. Okay, so nagbalhin sila diri sa Negros Occidental, and sooner or later, no, nakaminyo guro sila pod og mga Negrenses, and that is why nga some of the inhabitants are of pure or mixed heritage. So again, 84% of the residents in Negros Occidental speaks in Hiligaynon. Okay? Syempre because we have linguistic ties with Iloilo. But the 16% speaks Cebuano. Kami ana, no, we are part of the 16%. Especially kami, no, mga cities na dire, cities and towns nga gafe sa Tanyon Strait. So that is why there are cities that have a mix of both Hiligaynon and Cebuano as their spoken language. So, Sagay, mixture of both because it faces Iloilo and Cebu. Overall, no, even though we speak different languages, Filipino and English is still widely spoken so that we can understand each other, and at the same time, it is used for educational, literary, and official purposes. Well, let us now proceed to on profile again, no? Demographics of Negros Occidental. So, if we compare Negros Occidental in terms of population sa Tibuok, Kabilugan sa Visayas, we are the second most populous province. Pinaka number one is Cebu. Okay? And we also have the second largest number of congressional districts and the seventh most populous, okay, fourth if highly urbanized cities and independent urbanized cities based on the 2015 census. And up until now, we are still, 2024, we are still the largest population, okay, si Negros Occidental. Let us now proceed to religion. So with religion, Catholicism is our predominant religion, and we have large diocese diri, no? Madagko na to nga diocese, Roman Catholic Diocese sa Negros Occidental, kay ang Bacolod, San Carlos, and Kabangkalan. In fact, I think two of the schools, I don't know if Kudkod is still part of San Carlos, no? But there are two schools that are under the jurisdiction of the Diocese of San Carlos. No? Our Lady of Peace Mission School and Our Lady of the Mountains. No? Dako actually ang diocese ni San Carlos. So, man ang mga major diocese na to within Negros Occidental. So, aside from Roman Catholicism, okay, since over 2 million man ang adherents or ang practice of Roman Catholicism sa Negros Occidental, naapoy ga practice og other Christian denominations. Okay? Like Baptist, Aglipayan, Iglesia ni Cristo, Seventh-day Adventist, and Evangelicalism. So, we also have our brothers and sisters sa nga nag-practice of Islam, no, Muslim brothers and sisters. So basically, 1,842 of them practices Islam. Let us now proceed to economy. So, muna siya ang medyo pinaka-importante because there are several industries nga nag-help support sa growth sa itong economy other than agriculture. But our main jud na to, no, that we depend on is agriculture. So we are known as the sugar bowl of the Philippines because our sugar industry is the lifeblood of the economy of Negros Occidental. Why is it called the lifeblood? Because our sugar industry, no, produces more than half of the country's sugar. And aside from that class, no, the sugar industry is able to provide not only income but also generate jobs to hundreds of Negrenses. Okay? So there are 15 sugar centrals located throughout the lowland areas of the north and west of the island, stretching from northwest along coast of the Visayan Sea and Guimara Strait. So asa mani ang mga larger mills? So there are 15. But ang larger mills kay na locate sa San Carlos, shut down actually diri sa San Carlos, no, years ago pa jud. Tigwa pa jud guro ko na tao na shut down na, no? La Carlota, Bago, Binalbagan, Kabangkalan, Sagay, Silay, Morsha, and Victorias. Out of all the larger mills sa 15 ka sugar centrals, ang pinakadako is ang nasa Victoria City, no, ang Victorias Mill. This is the largest sugar mill, not just in Negros Occidental, but ang Victoria's Mill is the largest sugar mill in the country. And not only that, no, kung ang Insular Lumber Company is the largest lumber mill sa tibuok kalibutan, so si Victoria's Mill pod is the world's largest integrated sugar mill and refinery. So sa Victoria's, ang largest sugar mill in the country or in the Philippines and also in the world. It comes to refinery, no,
largest integrated sugar mill and refinery. Sugar is transported from plantations to refineries by large trucks that use the national highway. So I think dili naman dyan na siguro new to us nga every time nga moagi ta sa highway, makaagi pod ta no, or kanang naa pod tay makit-an nga mga trucks nga gadala og mga tubo. Okay? Mga sugar canes, no? Kay para himuon siya into sugar. So, not only, no, sugar, but we also rely on the fishing industry. Asa man ni makit-an ang, or asa man ni prominent ang fishing industry? So, aside from Sagay, no, makit-an po siya sa Cadiz City and other fish ponds that dot the province. One of the country's largest copper mines is also found in Sipalay City. So, naapod ga-exist sa Sipalay ang cottage industry which produce handicrafts that made from indigenous materials. Even kanisa ko, ano, na may mga handicrafts po ang Calatrava, anong mga kuan nila, mga pandan bags nila, gina export man na siya. No, niya, gina kuha na po yung mga suppliers gikan sa ano, like, sila ang suppliers actually, sorry. Kasi ang Calatrava ang suppliers na ginapadala nila sa Cebu, then gina-hand paint na siya, and sold for a higher price. Okay. Kay, customized man siya. And then, nag-inig ko'y pandan bag myself, no, sa gikan sa Calatrava. Gina-customize naman na nila. Palit ni mo ang extra large nila with 550 pesos and made siya from durable material. So, maundro na kay noon man sa pandan ang Calatrava. So, mapuna ilang marag. Other than their way of life dito, no, mapuna ang ilang mga handicrafts kung gina-produce. And ginabaligya sa other cities, even outside of Negros Occidental. It had made mention that the largest copper mines sa Philippines kay nakalocate sa Sipalay. And that is why nga ato ang province itself is rich in mineral deposits. Daghan kag makita ang mga minerals actually class nga pwede siya sa agriculture and then na po yung mga metallic pod nga ginagamit no for metalwork. Sorry, kabana rin sa mga iron. So, there are minerals that abound in the province that are primary copper with estimated reserve of 591 million metric tons and gold ore with estimated reserve of 25 million tons. Silver and molybdenum deposits are also abundant as well as non-metallic minerals. So, napo kay mga for metallic work ko, mamana siyang copper, gold ore, no? Pero ang kanang kuan, kanang mga non-metallic minerals, muna siya ang suitable class for agriculture, okay? And also for industrial uses. So, notwithstanding its great potential, unfortunately, the mining industry in Negros Occidental has remained virtually dormant since the biggest copper mine in Sipalay suspended its operation in the year 2000. Okay. Now, just like ang katong sa Insular Lumber Company, guys, ano nga, it's a double-edged sword. It could be either a blessing or a delay, no? Kay, syempre, on the other side of it, it can produce, no, it can also help the economy, no, and the city to grow. Pero, the and then also generates jobs also for sagay nuns. The other bad side of it is that, it's not good for the environment. Ano po na yung matabo po kaning sa largest nga copper mine, no? Sa Sipalay. So, imagine nga, known daw ko no ang Toledo for copper mining, pero ang pinakadako rin ay nga copper mine is not actually found in Toledo, but in Sipalay. Largest in the entire Philippines. Unfortunately, gisuspend lang siya atong 2000. Okay? Year 2000. So, mauna siya guys, no nga, naman po siya bad effects sa environment. No? So, it's also a good thing to shut it down. Although, dagay man noon tani og mga opportunities nga ma-provide na siya like for jobs. But syempre, pinaka-vital jud is the preservation of the environment. Okay, other than agriculture, fishing, and also mining as our main source na to for economic growth, center po ang Negros Occidental for Commerce and Finance, specifically in Bacolod City. So daghan sila oil companies, factories, bottling plants. May mga bottling plants no kanang Tanduay. Ah, sana oh, kana karayon kuan kanang Coca-Cola na naman Dolce Bacolod. Allied industrial businesses, steel fabrication, power generation. So diri sa San Carlos no largest jud may nga solar farm for renewable energy in the entire Philippines. And then we have agribusiness, prawn culture, aquaculture ventures. So appeal na po na ang BPO or Business Processing Outsourcing Hub ng mga call centers, no? So Bacolod has an estimated 35,000 workforce in the IT BPO industry working in 20 major companies. And basically, some of these BPO companies gani kay nag-extend na siya sa other smaller cities. Even here in San Carlos City class, na may Empire One, Concentrix, nga nampud sila office do dito sa Bacolod. So, extend po sila kay syempre ga-expand ang BPO industry in the province. So, sa mga different BPO companies nga nag-operate sa Bacolod City. So, we have Convergys. So, kanyang mga sikat, no? Siyempre, Convergys, Teleperformance, TTEC, Focus Direct International, Panasiatic Solutions, Ubiquity Global Services, Transcom, and iCore. So, as of 2019, so this is not updated information, no? But as of 2019, Negros Occidental has a total of 13 operating PEZA-registered IT parks and centers. So, before ta mo proceed, no, just an additional information. In 2012, 2-hectare portion of the 4-hectare Paglaom Sports Complex was partitioned for the construction of the provincial government-owned Negros First Cyber Center. So, there is a cyber center, no? As an IT BPO outsourcing hub with a budget of 674 million pesos. So, asa man ni siya na-locate? Na-locate siya sa Lacson Corner, Hernais Streets in Bacolod, and offers up to 22,000 square meters. So, na-mix na siya. Dili lang BPO companies ang naa, but also commercial spaces for other businesses. So, ang mga facilities, no, ana sa IT BPO outsourcing hub, kay mix siya with information technology, commercial support facilities, and common IT facilities. So, initially, no, residential zone man siya, pero gireclassified ang kaning IT BPO hub sa Bacolod as a commercial zone. Gi-approve ni siya sa Comprehensive Zoning Ordinance. And we have also contributed, no, sa income, no, sa NASOD with by 2014, no, with an average of 3.332 billion pesos ang ato ang na-contribute, and isa ta sa mga highest nga na-contribute sa income in all of the Philippines. So, proceed to food and agriculture. So, Negros Occidental's output for more than 1 million metric tons of crop from the year 2000 to 2003 accounts for nearly half of the country's sugar production in an industry that generates an estimated annual revenue of more than 18 billion. So, kanina ato nasulti nga 15, no, ang sugar mills in the province, and daghan kay sila mga dagko nga sugar mills. Unfortunately, for this day, no, gamay na lang ang nabilin. So, 10 na lang ang presently operational. And Victoria's Milling Company has the highest rated capacity with 15,000 tons of cane per day. And di naman dito ma-surprise ana, because Victoria's Milling Company is the largest sugar mill and refinery in the Philippines and even in the world. Kita for a while, okay, let me just charge my laptop. Okay. So, syempre, no, dili man jud sa tanang panahon we rely on our sugar industry. Na ay times nga, oh, since volatile po lang ato ang kuanon, ay times nga it could be unpredictable. and dili ta ka rely jud ana most of the time. So that is why nag-shift ang focus pod no sa province, dili lang siya more on sugarcane alone. So nagbalhin pod sila sa mga high value crops and alternative industries. So with this diversification, so meaning nag-diversify ang province na not only sugar ila ang i-produce but also other crops, no? So nimo siya og successful venture sa province to divert into other high value crops, okay? So production of rice, the basic commodity for food security, has been increasing, and by 2003, annual output of 437,000 metric tons of palay was 33% better than 2 years ago. Okay, so with the province successfully quarantined from the foot and mouth disease and even bird flu, so not only high value crops ang ato na produce, but also livestock and poultry, which nag-increase no in 2003 with 49,000 metric tons exceeded estimated local demand by 18%. Furthermore, no, napod ang fishing. Kaya syempre, the fishing industry can widely seen not only in cities like Sagay, no, but also like in Cadiz. So, nine of its cities, 16 of its municipalities located along the coastline depends on the fishing industry for their livelihood. So let us now proceed to culture and the arts. So Negros Occidental has long been a center of culture and the arts. The wealth brought about by the sugar industry made sure that the Negrense Principalia enjoyed an above average standard of living. So for example, we have Silay City, and it is dubbed as the Paris of Negros. Why? Because it is the cultural and artistic center of Negros Island region. Na daghag na preserve ng mga heritage houses that were declared by the National Historical Institute. Okay? So, 30 no, kabuok heritage houses. Ang pinaka-popular out of them all is the Balay Negrense, which is the hometown of the National Artist of the Philippines for Architecture, Leandro Locsin, and International Mezzo-Soprano Conchita Gaston. So this blossoming in art was due to the economical importance of the area during the Spanish era. So if you go to Silay, and I think some of you have already been there sa katong mga tour ninyo na nakita na ko last semester, up until today, makita Japan nimo ang strong influence of the Spaniards through architecture because naka-preserve jud og maayo ang mga heritage houses dito. Okay? So, Negros has become the most Hispanized and pro-Spanish area due to the enormous investments of Spain in the sugar business. And muna siya class no, nga muna kalabanan sa muna mga hasinderas ko no, sa Negros Occidental, mga hasinderas kay kalabanan sa mga gapuyo dito kay mga mestizo, mestiza. Okay, syempre, no? Ang mga naa sa Luzon, like what I've said, nagbalhin sa Negros to continue with the sugar industry because our land is suitable for agriculture. So aside from Silay City, you know, having preserved 30 heritage houses and naka-preserve up until this day ang Spanish influence sa tipod class, no, makita pod nato, especially sa largest sugar mill in the Philippines, ang Victoria's Milling Company. Sulod Silan Chapel is the world famous, so dili lang siya famous here in the Philippines, but even outside of our country, is the famous mural of the Angry Christ, painted by the artist Alfonso Osorio. Okay? So katong wala pa kita sa Angry Christ, let me show you a picture. Wala ko nabutang din rin. Wait lang. Let me show you a picture of the Angry Christ. Actually, it is painted with bright colors. That is why it's called the Angry Christ. Ano siya, no? With use of red, yellow. Very vibrant kaayo siya class. The Angry Christ. Ay, wait. Wala na ako na share screen. Wait lang. Muna siyang itsura sa The Angry Christ. Painted in bright colors. Okay, so muna siya. Si mural na the altar. Then, napan sa may ceiling, no, yung ani. Ang God the Father sa babaw. Holy Trinity. Holy Spirit nakita, dre. I-open para mas ma-appreciate pa rin ninyo. Okay, so muni siya, if you look here to your right. Kita niyo the Holy Trinity, no? Father, Son, Holy Spirit. So this is in the chapel, no? Church of the Angry Christ, inside Victoria's Milling Company. Okay, so who painted the Angry Christ? It was painted by artist Alfonso Osorio. So, he is actually a scion, no? Scion of the Osorio family who owned the mill. The Negrenses' joy de vivre is a manifest in the various festivals all over the province. Foremost being the famous Mascara Festival of Bacolod, Pasalamat Festival of La Carlota, Bailes de Luces of La Castellana, and Jempre Pinta Flores Festival of San Carlos City, which we participated in Sinulog. No? I don't know if naka-participate may Sobancon, pero sa Sinulog naka-participate na may. And also sa Panaad. Okay? So, sa background sa mga festival, nakita ko siya Pinta Flores because the word Pinta meaning painted ones and Flores meaning flowers. So, the cat suit na ginasulob, no? Ginapinta lang dyan, ang bodysuit, ginapinta lang dyan na siya. That is the signature of Pinta Flores. And then, it is also painted with flowers. And usually, ang kanang mga dancers, kay gawir sila mga like different mga flower designs, mga butterflies, no? Ay, doon nga ng flowers. So, di man dagag flowers ang San Carlos. So, there are other local festivals that are also featured aside from kaningi pang mention nako during the famous Mother of All Festivals or Festival of All Festivals rather, which is the Panaad sa Negros Festival. This is held every April at the 25-hectare tree-lined Panaad Stadium in Bacolod. So ano gitawag siya Festival of Festivals because tanan nga mga festivals sa tibuok kabilugan sa Negros Occidental would come together and showcase, no, their history, arts, culture, tourism, trade, commerce, and industry through their festival. And then, not only festival, but also kanang nasilay kanang mga booth, no? Or kanang ilahang mga kiosk, kung din nila nagbutang silang mga local products, no? Other pa rin nga mga materials that promotes their city or province. Oh, not province, municipality. Okay? Mga mismis, no? Panaad sa Negros. April. Since we did mention of the Panaad sa Negros Festival, so unsa man ni ang meaning aniniya for those who are not yet aware of what it is. So, the Panaad sa Negros Festival, or simply called as Panaad Festival, sometimes spelled as Pana-Ad, is a festival held annually during the month of April in Bacolod, the capital of Negros Occidental in the province of the Philippines. So, what is the word Panaad? In Hiligaynon, the word Panaad means vow or promise. The festival is a form of thanksgiving to the divine providence and a commemoration of a vow in exchange for a good life. So usually, kung natin mga festivals, diba, it's more on Thanksgiving, sa good harvest, and then protection sa mga tao, and then in honor of their patron saint. So syempre, si Panaad, since dira man dyan na magtapok, no? Dira man dyan na mag-come together ang tanan ng mga municipalities and cities. It's basically a vow in an exchange for good life. Okay? Form of Thanksgiving. So the celebration is held at the Panaad Park, which also houses the Panaad Stadium and is participated in by the 13 cities and 19 towns of the province. That is why it is dubbed as the mother of all festivals. So, basta yung matingala mo nga, no, Sinulog is considered the mother of all festivals. And not, like, abin ako ang Panaad, ma'am, no? Nga no, naman po lang Sinulog. Ang Sinulog is basically also dubbed as the mother of all festivals there in Cebu because not only that it's the oldest festival, but at the same time, pinaka-popular, no? Daghan kaayo ang mo-travel to Cebu just to partake in Sinulog. Naamputay ko ang Festival of Festivals ang Cebu, which is the Pasigarbo sa Sugbo, like their own version of Panaad sa Negros. Siyempre, Sugbo man na ang tawag sa province of Cebu, no? Sugbo. And that is why Pasigarbo. Pasigarbo is ipasikat, no? Pasigarbo ang meaning sa Bisaya. No, kaya Bisaya man ang mga Cebuano. So, sa Bisaya, Pasigarbo is ipasikat. Okay? Pasigarbo sa Subo. So, ito ang Panaad. Siyempre, ligay nun, man. Panaad sa Negros. So, the first Panaad... Sorry. No, mixing. So, the first Panaad sa Negros, as naman siya na-held, no, sa Capitol Park and Lagoon. So, 3 days lang to siya. 3 days lang to siya ang affair in 1993, which started in April 30. That is why every April na ang Panaad Festival. So, the festival was held at the Lagoon fronting the provincial capital, for the first 4 years. So, within 4 years, dira na siya ang venue sa Panaad sa Negros. Okay? 3 days lang siya, and nagsugod siya atong 1993. Later on, since nagkadako man ang festival, damo na ang nag-join, so they had to locate to a more spacious venue. That is why, in 1997, they had to transfer the festival sa reclaimed area near the Bredco Port. Okay? And then, pag-construct na sa Panaad Stadium and Sports Complex, dito na po sila gibalhin, no, sa Panaad Park as the permanent home na jud sa Panaad Festival. Kay gamay ra biya jud kayo ng Capitol Park, no, sa nakaagto na og Bacolod, gamay ra ng Capitol Park, kay daghan ra ba kaayo ang ning appeal ning join sa Panaad sa Negros. So muna ning transfer sila permanently dito sa Panaad Stadium. Okay. So we will end early for tonight. I know nga we have things to prepare pa for. You have things to prepare pa for your upcoming abilidaran. So we are just going to at least, no, ang dili mong gukuma most probably by tomorrow 2 sections ang dili na ko ma-discussan ani, no? So at least maka-catch up man lang sila. We are just going to end it here. We are going to continue the discussion by next week. Kung manunjo na to na siya, then we are going to have an activity based on the history and cultural background of Negros Occidental. So early dismissal lang ta. Do you have any questions? I know ang uban kay busy sila preparing for the abilidaran. No, I am excited on Friday and also on Saturday kung how your event will turn out, no, and I know that you will also do well, no.
Miss, good evening, Miss Diba, judge sa abilidaran.
Yes, I am one of the judges and together with me is my co-teacher as well. I will be bringing one of my co-teachers sa HM. He is a graduate from Nurso. So ba si sir? Ano? Oh yeah, Nurso di ay. A graduate from Nurso, HM, graduate po siya. Then ka masteral na rin sa LCC. So I'm going to also bring him because he's also invited by Doc Mel. So can't wait to see you all. on Friday. Murag, I think you know already naman kung unsa nga categories, no? Ang ako nakita nito is pralines. Pralines, sa pa to? Kanang inyuhang events proposal, no? Bed making, sumara man na siya. So anyway, see you on Friday. Personally, na rin na makita na rin mo on Friday and Saturday. 2 days man ang amuapod nga pag-judge. Do you have any questions or things that you would like to clarify before we will end our discussion tonight? We'll end early lang, no?